The label is the law. This is a common expression, but what do we mean by it? First and foremost, the label is a legal document. It's approved and registered by the EPA when they are satisfied that if you use the product according to the directions, the users, the consumers, and the fish and the wildlife will be protected. On the other hand, if the product is not used according to the directions, there can be illegal pesticide residues on the crops, and you can be held legally responsible for any damages. The label also allows manufacturers to sell the product, and it's used by the state and federal government to control the distribution, sale, storage, use, and disposal of the product. Another important thing the label provides is that it gives physicians and emergency personnel all the information they need to identify the product and treat patients in the event of an accident. And for you, most importantly, it's a good reference. Nobody can possibly memorize all the details involved in every pesticide they might use on their farm, and you don't need to. It's all right there on the label. What we're going to do next is to take an example pesticide label and go through piece by piece what that label contains. The first thing you should notice on the first page of any pesticide label is the trade name or brand name of the product you're using. In this case, our example product is Serenade ASO. Be aware that very minor differences in brand names can indicate very different chemical formulations. As an example of what we mean, we're going to look at two different chemical formulations for Roundup, which is one of the more common herbicides available. On the left, we have Roundup Pro, and on the right, we have Roundup Quick Pro. If you were to look at these very quickly in the pesticide shed, you might easily confuse them for one another. The names are very similar, the colors and the logos are very similar. However, if you look down on the active ingredients list, you find that Roundup Pro on the left is 41% glyphosate, whereas Roundup Quick Pro on the right is 73% glyphosate, plus 2.9% diquat. So that tells you right away that Roundup Quick Pro is a much more concentrated product and that it includes two different pesticides and is therefore likely to kill a much wider range of pests than the Roundup Pro. If you were to read further into this label, you would find that there are two very different sets of instructions for mixing these two pesticides and that the risks to the users are different. So it is always important to look carefully at the labels. Getting back to our example label, the label is also going to tell you what kind of pesticide you are dealing with. In this case, Serenade ASO is an aqueous suspension biofungicide, and a biofungicide is a product composed of beneficial microorganisms such as fungi and bacteria that are used to control plant pathogens. The label also includes an ingredient list, which is broken down into active ingredients and inert ingredients. The active ingredient is what actually provides the pest control. In this case, the active ingredient in Serenade ASO is Bacillus subtilis, which is a bacteria commonly found in soil that can be used to help control plant pathogens. Our example label for Serenade ASO also includes this logo for OMRI, the Organic Materials Review Institute. OMRI approves which pesticides can be used in certified organic operations nationwide. However, there are two issues to keep in mind. First, OMRI approves pesticides nationally, but states do have the right to impose further restrictions, and in some cases they do. Second, OMRI updates its list frequently, making it possible that the product could have been taken off the list after the EPA approved the label. We recommend that certified organic operations check with the certifier before using a pesticide, regardless of whether or not the OMRI logo is on the label. All pesticides will also contain a net content statement. In this case, we know that this container of Serenade ASO contains 2.5 gallons of the product. The label also contains the name and the contact information for the manufacturer. The EPA assigns a registration number to the product when it is registered. You'll be asked for this number if there's ever an accident or a liability claim. Some pesticides also have an EPA establishment number. This number is assigned to identify the facility that produced the pesticide in the event that the manufacturer has more than one factory where they produce the same product. The label also contains a signal word, which gives you an indication of the level of toxicity of the pesticide. Pesticides with the signal word danger are products that are highly toxic. A teaspoonful or less by mouth can cause death. These products are mandated to have a skull and crossbones picture printed on the label. However, it is important to keep in mind that these symbols are only meant to warn you of extreme danger. The lack of a skull and crossbones picture on the labels does not mean that it is completely harmless. All pesticide labels will also include a first aid statement, which will give you information on what to do in the event of an emergency. In some cases, they will also include emergency phone numbers. The precautionary statements will give you detailed information on the hazards to humans and animals caused by the pesticide. They will tell you a variety of information, such as what are the routes of entry of the product, or how does it get into the human body to cause damage. They will also give you information on what kind of personal protective equipment or PPE to wear when you utilize this pesticide. Keep in mind, you can always choose to use more PPE than is required by the label. The label will also include information about environmental hazards and how to prevent them. In the case of Serenade ASO, the label says, "Do not apply directly to water." The label also contains directions for using the product. For example, here it tells you that the REI, the restricted entry interval for this product, is 4 hours, which means workers should not be allowed back into the field that has been treated until 4 hours after the treatment has occurred. The label contains information on how to safely store and dispose of the product. However, state laws will vary, so you should never assume that this is a complete list of all the regulations that may apply in New Hampshire. The label contains a section on general use information. This tells you in more detail what the product is and how it is best used. For example, we can read here that for maximum effectiveness, you need to apply Serenade ASO prior to or in the early stages of disease development. This tells you that Serenade ASO is primarily a preventative product and not a curative one. The label contains information on how long you need to wait after you apply the product before you can harvest the crop. This is sometimes called the pre-harvest interval, or alternatively, the number of days to harvest, or DTH. The label will always include specific instructions on how to mix and apply the product. The label will also tell you which crops the product may be used on, which pests it may help control, and how much of the product to use to achieve that control. As a final note, let's talk for a moment about resistance groups. As we all know, one of the concerns with pesticide use is that eventually the pests may develop resistance to the pesticide. In order to help pesticide users manage for this problem, scientists have grouped pesticides together according to the way they attack the pests, i.e., according to their chemical activity or their site of action. Each of these groups is then given a group number, or a group number plus an initial. For the user, in order to minimize your risk of developing resistance, you alternate between products from different groups. Some newer labels are now listing these groups. Serenade ASO does not, and in this case it is not applicable because biological control products are not given groups. Your crop guide will contain more information on this topic. As a pesticide user, it is your responsibility to make sure you have a legible label with your product at all times. If you lose your label or it becomes illegible, you can find a new one by going to the website shown on your screen or by typing CDMS into a search engine.